Welcome to Department of Electronics and Telecommunication at Vidya Alankar Institute of Technology. In this department, we have taken this new initiative to start our own YouTube channel. In this YouTube channel, we are going to upload all our experiments video, value-added course video, or any other important videos. This material will be available to all the students in Mumbai University, and this material will help students to enhance their learning, not just in their classroom, but even outside the classroom. I hope that everyone will like this our effort, and in case of any query, comments, anything, they can put it in comment box. Thank you.
Welcome to Nano Electronics One Lab. Today we are going to design a self-biasing JFET. This is the circuit diagram. As you can see, the drain is given VDD and the gate and source are grounded through the resistors RS and RG respectively. Now, in order to calculate the ID and VDS, these are the equations required. So, in order to calculate ID, firstly, KVL is applied from gate to source, which gives us the equation minus VGS is equal to minus ID. Now, to calculate ID, we have a formula which is this: ID is equal to IDSS 1 minus VGS upon VP the whole square. This equation will give us two value. The lower value of ID is selected, and now in order to get the value of VDS, KVL is applied from drain to source. We get this equation, and from this VDS is calculated. That's all. Let us implement on the breadboard.
So this is the breadboard implementation of self-biasing JFET. The JFET used here is BFW11. So this is the JFET BFW11. Here we can see the notch. The closest pin to the notch are these two pins. So in order to know which one is the body bias pin, we need to connect the body to the pin. Since we are getting the continuity, so this pin is the body bias pin, and this is the source drain gate. Now, as we know that we have used three resistor with a supply of 10 volt. The values of resistor are 3.3, 1 and 1. So now we'll apply the voltage and check the output. So this is the circuit. The power supply is already set at 10 volt. The positive supply is given here and the negative supply is given here. As we have discussed the formula of IDS and VDS, we get the calculated value of ID, which is 1.8 milliamps, and the value of VDS is 4.1 volt. Now we'll observe the values on the multimeter. So now we are going to observe the value of VDS. So VDS is drained to, as we can see, we are getting the reading of 4.45 volts, which is somewhat similar to our calculated values. Now we are going to calculate ID. For that we need a milliammeter. Connect the milliammeter to check the value of ID. So as we can see, the observed value is 2 milliamps, which is similar to our calculated value, which was 1.8 milliamps. That's it for the self-biasing circuit. Thanks.